A drop box where citizens can put their written concerns and complaints about corrupt government officials and workers, crimes, illegal drugs, and other violations. That's what officials of the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission and the Department of Transportation installed at the so-called Katarungan Desk at the MRT North Avenue Station Tuesday. It is the first in PACC's plan to put up similar desks in public transportation terminals and barangay halls in the country. PACC Commissioner Greco Belica says citizens have the option to send anonymous complaints. The desk is manned by a policeman who will send the drop box to the PACC office once a week. The contents of the drop box will be evaluated by the PACC, and if the complaint warrants action from another government agency for verification, case buildup, or case filing, it will be forwarded to the relevant office.
Ang success po kasi ng anti-corruption campaign will heavily depend on the information that is gathered. So, pagka kakaunti ang impormasyon, mahina ang anti-corruption campaign. Pero yung pagka bultong impormasyon, then marami natatrabaho.
MRT3 po kayo na hindi na lamang puntahan ng mga tao para makarating po sa kanilang patutungan. Ngunit puntahan na po ng tao upang makarating po sa katarungan.
In 2017, the Department of Interior and Local Government ordered the use of drop boxes in provincial, city, municipal, and barangay halls for anonymous tipsters to put in the name of drug suspects and corrupt officials. The plan, however, was met with criticisms from the Commission on Human Rights and a lawmaker, saying the method is prone to abuse and may expose an individual to mistaken arrest. The CHR says it would be better if PACC's drop boxes will focus on getting concerns regarding the delivery of public services. CHR spokesperson Attorney Jacqueline Deguilla adds, due process should be observed on drug suspects reported by anonymous tipsters. Belica, meantime, gave this assurance.
Hindi naman kami a-action ng walang verified, walang verification, din na-validate ng information. Kaya nga po ito investigan. Yung mga allegations nila will be validated and the persons accused will be asked to answer. And then based on documents and evidence, yun po magiging basis ng amin pong endorsements and report.
Belica says the PACC will compile the public complaints reported through Katarungan desks and submit a report to the Office of the President. In 2016, the government launched the President's Hotline 8888, which is also dedicated to receiving complaints against fixers, scalawag officials, and poor government services. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News. We'll be right back.